What's going on, everyone? Austin John plays here, and today I'm going to be going over how you can get shiny Pokemon in Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. Just a heads up, a vast majority of this video is going to be late game content, whether you consider that a spoiler or not. Before large portions of things that may be spoilery are going to be shown on screen, there is going to be a spoiler bar at the bottom. But first, let me talk to you guys about some just general information in regard to the shinies of this game. Let's start at the very beginning. The base shiny rates of this game are the modern mechanics of 1 out of 4,096, not the previous during original Diamond or Pearl, which is over 8,000. That 1 in 4,000 96 is going to apply to a lot of things. First of all, your starter Pokemon. Your starter Pokemon can be shiny. When you're looking at it in the briefcase, it's not going to be shiny. However, when you're in your first battle against that Starly, it can be shiny. Next, wild Pokemon. Pokemon that are in wild patches all over the world can be shiny at base rate of 1,496. That includes surfing, fishing, static encounters, trees, things like that. That also goes for your box legendaries. That's right, Dialga and Palkia are also 1 out of 4,096 chance. You could save right in front of them, re-encounter with them, and there's a chance that they're going to be shiny. When they're appearing in the overworld, they will not be shiny. In addition, any other static encounters for legendary Pokemon in this game, including Romanus Park, where you're going to have access to the dogs, the birds, Mewtwo, Rayquaza, and other various legendaries that were not officially announced, so I'm not going to talk about it quite yet. Those all can be shiny. Likewise with Dialga and Palkia, in the overworld, when you see them, they will not be shiny, and in battle, they will be shiny. Everything that I've mentioned so far is 1 out of 4,096, and that is the only rate that it can be. Now you may ask, what about the shiny charm? We're talking about that later. In fact, to sum it all up, there's only two Pokemon in the entire game that are shiny locked, and they're the gifts that you're given for the Mew and the Jirachi. Literally nothing else is shiny locked. Next, let's talk about Grand Underground Encounters. When you enter a room, every Pokemon is going to be predetermined. Its stats, its shiny status, and more. Even if you save right in front of the Pokemon and re-encounter it several times over. The only way to re-roll what that Pokemon is to leave the room and walk back in to get a new Pokemon to spawn, which of course does not guarantee that that species of Pokemon is even going to show up the time that you walk in. In addition, you will not see if that Pokemon is shiny in the underground. That's right, the overworld sprites that you see walking around in those different biomes, they will never ever change form. If it is shiny, it will not appear shiny in the underground, in the wild sprites. There is some misinformation going on right now, and I just want to clear that up. No matter what, those models will not appear shiny. Next is called the Light Stone. That's the game's internal code. Light Stone is a 4-minute period of time after 40 Diglets have been found in the underground. During that 4-minute period, all of the underground spawns will have a shiny rate of 3 out of 4,096. So, really not great for that either. So out of all of the methods that I've covered before, not a single one of them is going to be affected by the shiny charm. Let's talk about the shiny charm. The shiny charm is not checked anywhere in the game for any of the spawns that I've talked about before. Some people have called it broken, however it's not broken. It's specifically stated that it is not being checked. If I would consider it broken if it was coded to be checked, but that code was not implemented properly, it's inactive. The shiny charm is inactive for all the overworld encounters, spawns, everything else. There is only one specific criteria that the shiny charm is active for, and that's going to be for egg hatching. The egg hatching mechanics for shinies are exactly the same from previous generation of recent, meaning that if you were to have a compatible Pokemon that is from a game that speaks another language mate with your Pokemon who is of a different language speaking than that one, and you have the shiny charm, then the base rate of that Pokemon is down to what's called the Masuda method, down to, I believe it's 1 out of 512. If you don't have the shiny charm, the Masuda method is 1 out of 683. Which brings us to the last fast method of finding shiny Pokemon in this game, which is the Poke Radar. The Poke Radar is obtained once you become champion, so it is locked to the post game. From this point on, I'm going to be talking very heavily about the mechanics of exactly how the Poke Radar works and how you can get shiny Pokemon for it. That is all I'm going to be discussing in this post game section. If you consider that a spoiler, you may want to add this to watch for later, although I guarantee playing the game early, you're gonna watch this video and then come back to this once you have the Poke Radar, because you're gonna need to understand the material once again. Trust me on that. The Poke Radar has been overly simplified since its last implementation, but with a caveat. The Poke Radar is a key item. It's gonna be that one right there at the top. And if you use that while standing in a patch of grass, patches of grass are gonna start rustling around you. It's then your objective to walk around to various patches of grasses, getting the same Pokemon over and over until you have a chain. The chain needs to be high enough for you to then have increased shiny odds. In addition, this is a way to have a Pokemon with guaranteed max IVs. And the best part about all of this is that the shiny rate, once you hit a chain of 40, has been changed from previous games, which was 1 out of 200, is now 1 out of 99. So let's go over your requirements. What are you actually going to need as a gamer in order to do this chain method? 1, you need to be in the post game. 2, you have to have the Poke Radar. 3, which is optional, is to have the app, which you get at your first time to Romanus Park. 4, you need repels. I recommend super repels. They used to be the best bang for your buck. I don't know if they still are. 5, you need Pokeballs. I'm gonna recommend repeat balls because you're gonna catch the same Pokemon a lot. And 6, depending on your situation, you may need specific Pokemon. Meaning that if you're going after Pokemon with low catch rates, you're gonna need to bring its health down and paralyze it. Or if you're going after a Pokemon that has self-damaging moves, you may need a ghost type. Or if you're going after a Pokemon that knows explosion or self-destruct, you're gonna need a Pokemon with the damp ability. Various things like that that have all remained true throughout, you know, hunting various Pokemon, right? In addition to that, if you have a false swiper and you're not able to get the Pokemon's health down guaranteed in one false swipe, you may want to consider making sure that you have 2 false swipers, because you are going to be able to swap Pokemon out during this. You just cannot leave a route, in addition to a long list of other things you cannot do. So the Poke Radar chain app, which my face is covering right now, I'm just going to move myself down just a little bit. In order to do a chain, you're gonna wanna go, and you're gonna want all those things that I just mentioned before. I'm having an Absol here, I'm having a Luxray. This is actually my last hunt that I did, and I got myself a shiny Starly. I've done this 3 times successfully. I have done this probably 40 times unsuccessfully. Before you begin, you wanna make sure that you've already taken out these trainers. Have I fought you? Yes, I fought you. Did I fight you? I fought you, good. We need to make sure that we do not encounter any wild Pokemon. For that, I'm gonna use a super repel. I'm gonna stand right in the middle and I'm gonna save my game. That's it. That's pretty much the whole setup for this. With this being mapped to my start button, I'm gonna hit up and you're gonna see that there are many patches of grass shaking. There are 3 different types of shaking grass that you can encounter. All 4 of these are the basic type of grass. The other one are an extremely large shaking piece of grass that has lots of leaves coming out of the middle. That means that that's a hidden ability of a Pokemon, and you have a 1 out of 128 chance to find that hidden ability Pokemon. And then the 3rd patch of grass is a shiny patch. So to start your chain, you have to choose what Pokemon that you want to hunt. All of these patches of grass have the exact same odds of having the Pokemon in this area. The only way you could impact that is if it's an electric or steel type and you have the appropriate abilities. I believe static and magnet pull, which can attract those 2 types of Pokemon. In addition, you're not going to want to save your game anytime going forward. So you're going to want to go to options and you want to make sure that autosaves are off. Great. So now pick any of them. Let's go for this one. Why not? It's a Starly. I don't want a Starly. I'm gonna close the game. I'm going to reopen the game on the same profile, and we're gonna try that again. All right, just where I was before. I'm going to reinitiate. I'm gonna pick any patch of grass. Oh, great, it's a Ralts. I would like a shiny Ralts. Let's do Ralts. It's now at this time that I would recommend pulling up a catch rate calculator like the Cave of Dragonflies one. If I were to throw a Pokeball with no damage on the Pokemon, I have a 41% chance to catch it. If I throw a repeat ball and I already have it registered, I have a 100% chance to catch it. Fantastic. I'm just going to throw repeat balls at this. And I have 48 of them. I should not need more than 48 Pokeballs. Fantastic, Ralts was caught. Soon as that's done, different patches of grasses are going to start rustling. By the way, if you just turn your game off and back on again, you may need to hit R in order for your counter to show back up. As you see right now, I have a counter of 1 for Ralts. Now it's your option if you want to knock the Pokemon out, or if you want to catch the Pokemon. And I'm going to recommend that you catch the Pokemon. The reason I recommend you catch the Pokemon is because the success rate of you doing the next chain is inherently dependent on only two things. Contrary to the previous iterations, just two things. One, how far away that patch of grass is. And two, did you knock out the Pokemon or did you catch the Pokemon? The overlay that you see on screen right now represents all of the spaces away from the player that the patches of grass can be. And you're gonna see down here at the bottom right, this is now 4 spaces away, and that's the best patch of grass to go to. Anything that's 4 spaces away, it doesn't matter if it's by a corner, or if it's by a side, or if there's 2 patches next to each other, none of that matters. Contrary to the previous games, none of that matters. All that matters is that it's 4 spaces away. The only reason you may not want to do patches of grass that are in corners or hidden behind trees or things like that is the situation that a patch of grass is in a really inconvenient place. Or say, for example, I'm in this top left corner and then both to the right of me and below me are patches of grass. Those are not good because they're 1 space away. The closest ring has a 53% chance to continue the chain. But if you go to the furthest patch away, there's an 83% chance that that chain is going to continue. And that's if you knock out the Pokemon. If you catch that Pokemon, there is a 93% chance that your chain is going to continue. That means that there is a 7% chance that if you do everything that I told you right, your chain is going to break. And I'm going to tell you one very important piece of information here. 7% is a lot more than you think it is. That means if we were to do the compound chance for you to go from a chain of 1 to a chain of 40, the chance of you actually succeeding in that is 5.49%. 5.49% for you to get to a chain of 40. Now, why is 40 such a magical number? Because Kefotix, Kurt on Twitter, one of the main data miners right now, has found the chance of you finding a shiny Pokemon based on your chain. And we can see that it starts at 4,096. And then after your 20th chain, we're looking at about 1 out of 1,800. However, once we hit 35, you'll notice that it no longer goes on this nice smooth curve that brings it down to 1 out of 1,200. Instead, it plummets. And once you get to 40, it becomes 1 out of 99. It will never go below 1 out of 99. However, it's not so much about going above 40, it's about getting to 40. In addition, while we're looking at this chart and talking about the data mine, Kurt has also found that the game's code is not implemented correctly. So therefore, this thing is broken. It's supposed to be any Pokemon between your 20th and your 29th is guaranteed 2 max IVs, 30th and 39th should have 3 max IVs, and 40th onward should have 4 max IVs. However, that code is not implemented correctly internally. Therefore, your 20th encounter has 2 max IVs, 21st through 29th does not, 30th encounter has 3 max IVs, and your 40th encounter has 3 max IVs. Now you may ask, well, is there something for 5 max IVs? There is. Your chance of getting a 5 max IV Pokemon only exists, 100% guaranteed, at 100 of a chain. The chance of you going from 1 to 100 flawlessly is 1 out of 1,418. Which brings us back to doing the actual chain. Oh, my repel ran out, perfect. We're just gonna go to the furthest one away. We're gonna catch this Pokemon, and that means that we have a 93% chance to go to chain number 3. Perfect. As you can see, we're now on number 3. Before we knew the rates or anything else like that, I do have that shiny patch and I did a chain of 45, not really fully understanding how it worked and that I could have stopped at 40. But then I hunted for a Ditto, a chain of one, I had a shiny patch. So it can happen between 1 and 40. It could totally happen. I just showed you the odds of it happening. And in my opinion, that's pretty much a full odds ditto shiny right there. So yeah, as long as you make sure that you go to the furthest spot away and you encounter that Pokemon, you have that 97% chance to continue the chain. There are many things that can break your chain other than just the 7% chance that it does happen. If you get on your bike, that breaks your chain. If you encounter a different Pokemon, meaning your repel runs out, that breaks your chain. So make sure your first Pokemon in your party is higher than the Pokemon around you. If you encounter a trainer, that breaks your chain. If you go underground, that breaks your chain. If you turn the game off, that closes your chain. You can turn the game into sleep mode. That will not break your chain. Although I am going to recommend, if you need to take a break from this, to enter the battle screen and then put your game to sleep. It just seems a little bit safer. You know what I mean? Now, say for example, you're in a situation like this and none of your patches of grass are four away. Although we could clearly see the one at the top left is four away. You do have an option. You can then run 50 steps. Definitely just use the D-pad. You don't want to accidentally run into that patch of grass. Then reuse the Poké Radar. Then you're going to have four brand new patches. This is going to be important for later. We can see that the one at the top right is four patches away. We're going to go encounter that Ralts and hopefully get on to chain number five. Yeah, we made it to chain number five. That's amazing. It's just a matter of keep going to the furthest patch away, and I'll see you if it breaks or if I get to 39. I literally just turned the lights off. That was the same chain. It just broke. Just like that. I did everything right. That was the furthest patch away. The fact that I re-rolled using the Poké Radar doesn't make a difference. Just, that's the 7% chance. The good news is, all of those balls that I spent on those Ralts, you get them back just by reloading your save. And that's the importance of making sure that you turn off autosave. So here we are. I still have my 48 repeat balls. I'm just going to put down a Poké Radar search, go into this first one, and let's see what we're going to hunt. Ralts again? Ralts again! Yay! We're up to a chain of 5 and all is well so far. Chain of 12 and all is well. All right, we are now at number 19. That means that the next Pokemon that we encounter is going to have 2 guaranteed max IVs. We're at 23, and that's only a 20% chance to actually get up to this point, so that's pretty exciting. Okay, so I'm now at 29, and this is turning out to be a pretty lucky run so far, which means that the compounded chance to get here is about 12%, and the next Pokemon I get is going to have 3 perfect IVs. I've actually unpaused after every one at the chance that either we get a shiny, I see the hidden ability grass, or it breaks. Either way, it's content, right? I'm waiting for this to break. It's not breaking. 39. One, I actually wasn't expecting to get to 39 for the purpose of this tutorial, which means I essentially just did a successful shiny hunt. The next Pokemon that I'm gonna get is gonna be my 40th, and that's gonna be the most max IVs I could get, unless, you know, the snowball's chance in heck that you could get 100. Right now exists the chance of 1 out of 99. I'm gonna run a total of 50 steps, because 50 steps are required in order to recharge this bad boy. You can leave the grass if you wanted to for this. Just don't run into grass and don't leave the route. Then we just do it again. So now we're just gonna wanna go back and forth over and over again, re-rolling this. So great news, that's what hidden ability looks like. That's hidden ability grass versus regular grass. I was getting very distracted. And, yeah. By the way, very important thing that I now realize, make sure to unequip your bike and your digging stuff. Like, just make sure you have your Poké Radar and, like, one other item that won't cancel out a chain, like an old rod and not near the water. So you don't accidentally hit the bike, because I thought I almost hit the bike, like, my thumb went up on the D-pad. But anyways, that's a shiny patch. That's what the shiny patch look like. And we're gonna get ourselves a shiny Ralts. There we go. Austin John Plays Shiny Hunting Guide includes actual shiny patch showing up. Look at that blue boy. I'm gonna need a screenshot of that for re-recording without my face covering it up. I definitely want to use a quick ball. He's blue and yellow, and the kind of, well, blue and orange, and that blue and yellow? Yep. And it was a critical capture. Come on, could it be more guaranteed? I don't think it could. I just want to recap real quick here. As we can see, this is the 20th Ralts that I got, had two max IVs. This is the 30th Ralts that I got with three max IVs. This is the 40th one that I got with also three max IVs, and this one was the shiny one. As soon as you get it, save, right? Now I'm still in the middle of the chain, right? That means that I can walk down here, move 50 more spaces, reinitiate, and I could keep doing this over and over. And as long as I have max repels or super repels on me, I am guaranteed to get more shiny Pokemon. This was like two rolls later. Boom. Another shiny Ralts. All right, enough of this. We're all done with the video. There you have it, my dudes. That is every single way to get shiny Pokemon in Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. If you found this video helpful, do me a favor, hit the thumbs up button down below. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe, turn on notifications. Until next time, Austin John out.